Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to the Hearthstone Legendary Series Season 1 Finals. I'm Osmo Cutie, once again joined by Raynad and, of course, Savige. Fresh off his loss, but how did you feel overall your performance in this tournament?
Well, yesterday was a disaster, and I really regret bringing the Hunter. I think it was a mistake. But overall, I'm really happy with the games today, and I can't feel too bad about that last loss. It was a good series.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, there was like a few things that I was like unhappy with, like throwing the big game Hunter and blah, blah, blah. Boombot's going to face instead of the three minions. But it touched Hearthstone, and his worst Void Caller also like whiffed. So I think it was a good match, and I wish Silent Storm the best of luck.
Yeah, I saw how surprised you were when that Void Caller pulled nothing out, but... again, like you said, that is Hearthstone. Of course, coming up next, we do have Pinpingho taking on Chalky. And we did see Chalky earlier on in the day actually do pretty well with his Freeze Mage deck. Now, Rainer, what are your thoughts on Freeze Mage as opposed to some other mage choices like Mech Mage for this tournament? Do you think it's a good choice for him to bring that?
Yeah, about 90% of the Hearthstone I've played this week was just Freeze Mage. I played it a lot. It's actually a deck I got Legend with this season. And I'm a big fan of it. I think it's really strong and a lot of different tweaks you can make to it. But I think it's about as strong as Mech Mage, maybe slightly weaker. It just depends on the metagame. But, you know, it's one of those decks that just has some really lopsided matchups that are nearly impossible to lose. And it has some lopsided matchups that are nearly impossible to win. But we'll see how it goes. I mean, Chalky is playing against Pinpingho, which is one of the players in this tournament that has Kezzan Mystic. So I expect Freeze Mage to get thoroughly wrecked, and the other two decks are going to have to pull a lot of weight for Chalky.
Yeah, we saw Waifu earlier actually take the 50-50 with the Kazan Mystic to try and steal the ice block.
Yeah.
And he ended up taking the ice barrier instead, which could have been a big deal. He actually had the chance to proc it, but it's a big card, and it can just straight up win you the game in these matchups. So interesting tech choice.
It's just like Flare. Like, you just save it for the turn you kill them. Take the ice block and you win the game.
All right, yeah. So we did have a chance to speak with Pinpingho before the tournament that happened this weekend. So let's see what he had to say about this weekend.
My name is Kuo Pingho, known as Pinpingho. I'm from Taiwan and I play for White Spider. I think I like the card games and like all kind of board game. I used to play Go. I was like 6th on AGA, like American Go Association. Yeah, and it's just a game I can play. It's like, I'm not good at games like StarCraft and most those game requires reaction speed. I play Shaman the most. Like, I've been playing Shaman like since the earlier season. Like, when everyone was playing like mages and thinking that Shaman is really weak as mage, I was always able to build some deck that actually counters the meta, like the mage, the hunter. There's always way to do so. Yeah, Shaman is like a very versatile class. It's like, I don't think you will ever get to the top of meta, because it's not like as strong as like they don't have cards that as powerful like Innervate, and it's not like Hunter. They can deal like massive damage just using the hero power. Like, Shaman is like everything it does is like pretty like normal. It's like not overpowered.
Interesting words from Pinpingho. He really loves that Shaman. Almost his whole piece was just talking about that class and his love for it. Not many people pick Shaman coming into this one, so we'll have to see how that's going to work out for him. He's putting some interesting tech choices in there. He loves that Kazan Mystic. Him and Waifu actually had almost identical decks coming into this tournament, so it'll be interesting to see how that works out for him. Savige, are you familiar with Chalky's lineup right now? It was like Freeze Mage, Druid, Hunter. How do you think Shaman matches up against those guys?
Usually Shaman is awful against something like a Freeze Mage. Like, we are actually going to see that exact matchup in the first game. Mm-hmm. But the Kazan Mystic is the MVP, so he might be able to pull off a surprise with that. But I would still give the edge to the Mage player. Mm-hmm.
So does he play Kazan Mystic in the Shaman deck? Have we seen that?
think there was one.
It's in the Mage and Druid deck.
Weifu played Kazan Mystic and his Shaman.
Okay, so there probably is.
Yeah, because I think they collaborated a little bit. They came over here together, and they've been talking a lot, and their deck lineups are very, very similar. So,
in my honest opinion, if he just saves his Mystic for like the Ice Block, I don't think it's possible for Freeze Mage to win. I honestly don't.
I wouldn't expect a player like Ping Ping Ho to steal a barrier.
Yeah, he's an exceptional player, actually. Ping Ping Ho and Zalei were my two picks at the beginning of the tournament for winning the whole thing. Number one and two on my list because I was really impressed when I casted their games earlier in the series before the finals when they actually qualified. These players just really know what they're doing. And yeah, Ping Ping Ho, one of the two players to bring Mech Shaman to the metagame. I'm excited about that. This deck's just fun to watch. Mostly because it takes like 5 minutes to cast a game. Somebody gets lava bursted.
That's true. Yeah.
Well, I really like the hand by Chucky here. Both of the scientists in there.
Yeah, Chucky's hand's perfect. Getting Mad Scientist in the opening hand is just the dream with Freeze Major. Secrets are so powerful. And getting them out early makes your draw throughout the game that much more effective. Just not having secrets in your deck.
Mm-hmm. He even has the Frostbolt for the potential Mech Warper. And Explosive Ship is one of the best AoE in the early game.
Mm-hmm. So yeah, Ping Ping's draw has a lot of spells, a lot of burn. It's not exactly what you want early. You'd rather just have a lot of minions to start developing. Yeah. Might have to coin a removal spell here for this Mad Scientist.
Probably. With this hand, I would expect like an Anatron coin Rockbiter maybe. I guess you don't mind the Overload here that much because the next turn is like pretty bad anyway.
Doesn't feel too well.
Maybe you let it live so you can play both your dudes, get the extra damage from Cogmaster, and put Flame in my play. I would do that.
He hovered over there for a
He's
second.
Going to coin.
Alright. Doesn't want to overload just yet. Wants to be able to make a totem to go along with Cogmaster next turn at the very least.
Yep.
The totems in this mech deck aren't as threatening as the totems in most shaman lists, I think, but still pretty strong. Nice to weave those in when you can.
Yeah, a lot of times earlier on, you have cheaper minions to be able to fill up your mana, and you don't necessarily totem as often.
Is there any other option here but the scientist?
Yeah, you can ping the bubble. That's mostly the same thing. Then you next turn you sheep ping, and then you have a scientist rather than killing your own scientist off. Mm-hmm. So I think that might have been a bit better. It's tough to say.
It's pretty inconsequential at this point, but he did pull Ice Block as his first secret from the Mad Scientist.
Okay.
Doesn't really matter, though, because he's going to get the second one here.
Yeah. Right. Getting Ice Barrier first might be a bit better, because then I like to get like the free 16 points of life. Then it's like you're playing a 2-mana heal bot, you know, and then and then draw Ice Blocks later and just play them.
Yeah, you definitely want the Ice Barriers early on, but I don't think it's that big of a deal here because he's going to get both now.
I think Chalky only runs one Ice Barrier.
Oh, really?
Yeah, we casted him earlier and he only played one and he had a Mad Scientist and didn't pull anything out of his deck, so pretty sure he only runs one Ice Barrier as far as we could tell from earlier on.
That's interesting. Right, that Explosive Zip is going to be great. He could even Cone of Gold if he wants to.
I'm a big fan of turn 4 Cone when it's this effective. It even sets up the Noitron to die to the sheep.
Yeah.
Did just draw Doomsayer though, makes him want to hold on to his freeze a little bit more.
There goes the sheep. Now this draw from Bing Bing Ho is so important. You really don't want to hero power pass. Okay, well, yeah. That's playable.
That's good enough. So, yeah, I feel like Chalky really wanted to ping the bubble on turn 3. I'm not sure if Scientist was as good. Mm-hmm. Tough to say.
Now, how does Mech Shaman get over that hump later on in the game when they start to like run out of juice? Like, Mech Mage has like Archmage Antonidas to sort of get them through with that later game burn. How does a Shaman overcome that?
That's kind of the thing, because the Shaman really can.
Yeah.
It's a huge problem. It's the main problem with this deck, in my opinion.
Yeah, that's a really good point. I mean, you have a couple Azure Drakes, but it might not even come down to Kazan Mystic. Like, the Shaman might just run out of breaths.
Oh, wow. Okay. Well, that's as good as it gets with this deck. When you're about to run out of cards.
Yeah, he's going to be able to refill his hand as well. Put a reasonable size body on the board. Even though Chalky had a pretty decent starting hand, he hasn't drawn into any of his card draw mechanics, like the Arcane Intellect. So he's starting to run out of cards as well.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Chalky definitely needs to get his Acolytes and Arcane Intellects as soon as possible. Yeah. But he does have the Blood Mage, so next turn he can... Well, actually, he can't get two cards because there's nothing to kill it off to.
Have we seen Chalky playing Loot Hoarder?
Oh, right. Yeah.
I feel like I feel like he's skimping on card draw in this list. He's fitting Kona Colds in, maybe by shaving an Ice Barrier, but I don't think... Have you seen Loot Hoarder?
Osmo? I don't think I've seen Loot Hoarder or Novice Engineers. I know there's some Freeze Mages out there who like lean towards Novice Engineers or play both because they prefer the immediate draw over bigger body and later on draw, but I'm not sure. It's hard to say what he's been trying to fit in. I know... do some Freeze Mages run like one copy of Flamestrike?
Yes, most of them do, yeah. Because the board builds up and you need something besides Blizzard to actually remove minions at some point.
I think he might actually run two.
Okay. Yeah.
Which I thought was interesting when I saw it earlier.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, there's some variations. A lot of people have got one to replace it with something like Explosive Ship, so you have a bit more like options early game if you draw like two Flamestrike that obviously sucks in the starting hand.
Yeah.
So if you only run one, it's less likely to get an awful starting hand.
I was having a lot of fun with Clockwork Gnomes on stream, too. I was getting, like, in Freeze Mage, I just kept getting Stealth, and you'd, like, Stealth your Extraza, hit him in the face, Stealth Antonitis.
Wow, such a weak then.
Yeah. I like that Clockwork Gnome as sort of like a flex card in Freeze Mage. Could be a little bit inconsistent, though.
Double Lava Burst.
Wow.
So BM.
Both of these players are doing kind of bad right now. I think I would have liked the ping on the mech warper a tiny bit more, but it does signal the flame strike. Not sure if it matters that he knows it's coming. He could probably figure it out anyway.
Mm. Yeah, flame strike really is Mage's best card against Shaman. The board builds up and it's never with 6 health minions, so.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, man, just a turn earlier, that would have been insane. Still a good draw, though.
Yeah, as soon as he topdecks, like, his turn is something like a. Cookmaster or well, like both the Cookmaster I can already, but some really small minion, it's gonna be almost like just passing the turn.
Most mech shaman lists do play Doomhammer. Have we seen those yet out of these shaman decks?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we saw a Doomhammer from I think it was Weifu. I remember there was a Doomhammer this tournament that got Harrisoned.
Right.
But I don't remember which matchup that was actually in. So I didn't really play it.
It might have been the slower shaman deck, I don't remember.
Yeah,
I remember at least Silent Storm was running one.
Okay.
So it might not be in the mech shaman.
Oh, that's really good.
Yeah, it sure is.
That's a new Lothub.
Yeah, it's true.
Oh, it's...
And there's not really much point in using it right now, I suppose, just because...
The Time Rewinder?
Well, because he played the Lothub this turn, correct?
No, he just
played it last turn. Okay.
Yeah.
Well, then I guess so. He's trying to think what ways that Lothep could be taken off the board. And if he expects it, then a Time Rewinder to have come out from that, then how much is he going to value taking out that Lothep?
This is interesting. In my opinion, this would have been kind of obvious play, because I'm not sure what to save Time Rewinder for. But
right.
Maybe he has a plan. Like maybe he wants to use it with the Kazan, or... I'm not sure what exactly.
Oh, that's right. There is a Kazan Mystic in there. That's a good point.
Take two secrets. Whoa.
Wow.
Yeah. Oh, go in face. No fear of power, Mace.
I like it.
Yeah, he's sitting on 9 points of burn.
The one card that Raynad thinks sways his matchup, the Power Mace. Or it was Mech Mage versus Mech Shaman.
Yeah.
It went from unwinnable to Power Maces.
Unbeatable.
Unbeatable, yeah.
Coin Power Mace, yeah.
Now he's going for the Time Rewinder. Okay.
Well, I mean, the thing is, last turn, how much of a threat was there actually for him to take out the Lothep? Like, he had a big board. The best thing he could have done there was, like, Blizzard. Mm-hmm. And he knew that he could just take it back the following turn anyway, so.
I guess, but I feel like the amount of creatures from the Shaman is so limited at this point that he I would like try to be more careful to try to hold on to the ones that were on there already.
That's a good point.
Shaman just needs Kez and Mystic right now. Not just to stop the mage from having ice block, but just to develop his own ice block.
Just the power miss, but it's too late. That's game one, unless he lava bursts. Yep, that's.
Alright, Jackie takes it.
Wow!
No Kez and Mystic drawn. Freeze Mage takes first win. I think the first two matchups favor Chalky pretty heavily. But the second one is going to be Druid versus Hunter, and we've seen that kind of be an upset every time so far this tournament. So.
Yeah. Chalky never misses an opportunity for BM. So after having poor luck with the Freeze Mage yesterday, Chalky 3-0 today with that deck. He's on a rampage right now.
Yeah, beating Kez and Mystic lists.
Yeah, but I don't think this game would have still went the Shaman way, even if he drew the Kazan.
Yeah, he would have taken an ice block.
He had another ice block in his hand, and if there was a Kazan, he would have still put him down to one, and then pop the block and just kill him next turn. So in this game, it would not have been a swing in any case.
Yeah, that's a good point.
Well, we talked about Pimping Ho a little bit yesterday, and he was the player that actually participated in the most total weeks of the Legendary Series. He was first place in points, automatically qualified, even turned down an invite to one of the final weeks that we would have played in because he had already qualified through points. So he actually never won a week. He just plays so consistently high across the weeks that he actually qualified. And in a lot of the series, he'd be down 1-0, 2-0, and then be able to come back. So he's no stranger to being down in series. And he's a really calm player that plays very consistently, doesn't make a lot of mistakes. So I can imagine this series is going to go to Game 4, Game 5, but getting a little ahead of ourselves. Druid versus Hunter.
Savitz, am I wrong in thinking that this favors Hunter?
Yeah, I've been saying that. Too, but it can go either way.
Yeah.
But that's like the reason why I brought Hunter, so that I could beat the Druids, but it didn't go quite like that.
Yeah, it's crazy. A lot of players were saying that Hunter was a really good choice to bring here, but both players that brought Hunter, you and Max, were are at the tournament. We won't even see a Hunter in the semifinals. So it's just interesting that it worked out the way.
Oh, is this Scumbag Hunter or
yes.
Is this other Scumbag Hunter?
Well, it's
Face Hunter.
That is Chalky.
Okay. Well,
Worgen. In what?
Get him. Yeah, well, Worgen's a good card. That's much better than Clockwork Gnome.
I was talking to Chalky like right before this match, and I asked him what his favorite Pokemon card was, and he said it's Dark Slowking. And people are probably like, I don't know what the heck that is. You looked me in the eye and said, Dark Slowking, not regular Slowking.
Wow.
Dark Slowking is a card where you actually look at the top card in your opponent's deck, and you can choose to shuffle it back or leave it there. So you top deck and wreck your opponent from his own deck.
It's wow. Called Jace, man.
Yeah.
And it's sweet.
Is it the magic version of it?
Oh, yeah. That one did everything.
That's a good card across multiple disciplines, I suppose.
Oh, yeah. Well, Innervate Yeti's a little tempting against a faster deck. You just want to stem the bleeding as soon as possible, but I like the Wild Growth more. He's going to take a beating from his juggler, but overall, I think the better play.
Yeah, I like it too. But, I mean, if Chalky was playing the Freezing Trap Hunter, then it would have been truly awful because there might be just a Freezing Trap and then you waste your Yeti, but he has to play that Wild Growth sometime.
Did he keep Kazan Mystic from his hand? Oh, was that a card that he... Okay.
No.
Well, Chalky...
Wow.
Actually lost a game earlier because of that.
Oh, shocking. It's Huffer.
Wow.
It's always Huffer. I think we're like...
I would like
six out of seven with Huffers.
I would like to see Eaglehorn Bow there. But... I guess you gotta save that for going face.
Where? Yeah, there's a lot of minions to clear right now, so they're kind of not playing the Huffer. Saves the juggler.
Yeah, I don't like killing Huffer there. You're basically banking on your opponent not having any minions. Because if either your dude gets juggled, you get pretty good trades here from the Hunter side. I would like to see killing Knife Juggler there.
Okay, so he's not going to go for an Unleash.
Oh, that's very good for Ping Ping, the fact that went base right there.
I mean, you can't overlook the fact that it's like turn 5 right now, and he's at 12 health.
You can't not Unleash, right? Like, Unleash is just so much better than anything else here.
I agree, but I feel like he should have done that first, because the juggle from that Lepronome could have went to the Yeti, and then he couldn't Unleash anymore.
Yep. Wow. Definitely a mistake, but not punished.
Puts him down to 6.
Wow. Turn 4, and such, already down to 6. Oh, that's my goodness. That's really skilled.
Yep.
Such skill. Much wow.
Chalky really being rewarded for the in-depth decision-making this game. Very high-level point-and-click mechanics over the opponent's hero portion. Druid of the Claw comes down, but it's not going to be enough. Let's see how many emotes he can get in before this kill command to the face.
Just one.
Just one? Are we trading stuff in? There you go.
Okay, yeah.
All right.
Chalky with his signature Leper Gnome kill is going to take a very quick victory. Oh. In game number 2. No emotions.
That was incredibly one-sided.
Yeah. I mean, if the mid-range Hunter is a bad matchup for Druid, the face Hunter is a much worse matchup.
Mm-hmm. The story about Dark Slow King actually lasted about 60% of that entire match, so... That's pretty crazy.
Is there a light Slow King?
I don't know. I really don't know anything about Pokemon. I was just asking him because I wanted to ask him questions. Hmm. He's a fun guy to talk to. He's just very bright and interesting. If you guys ever get the opportunity out there to speak with Chalky, then take it as soon as you can. What was the last matchup?
It was something that was favored for Ping Ping.
I think it was Druid for Chalky and...
Mage.
Yeah, Mech Mage.
Okay. Mech Mage, yes.
All right, what are you guys' thoughts on this matchup?
I would bet on Bing Bing Ho.
Yeah, me too. I think I would like to see him keep Mirror Entity as well, which not enough players do against Druid. It's a better 3-drop than... It's just the best 3-drop in the deck against Druid.
It's a huge tempo play, because unless you have like a Zombie Chow, which you're most likely going to be playing earlier on to take that Mirror Entity, most likely you're going to be giving over something that's like... really huge.
Yeah, something that's just bigger than Harvest Golem, basically.
Yeah.
Mirror Entity is really good against Druid, but personally, I like to go like really aggressive to get the Mad Scientist and try to get it that way. Okay. Yeah, there's so much tempo there.
Mm-hmm. For sure.
And also, if you keep a Mirror Entity and you draw into Mad Scientist also, then it's kind of awkward.
Well, Wild Growth in the opening hand is...
not bad.
Gonna be pretty good.
Thinking about putting back Snow Chugger. One drops are important, but are they this important? I would keep the Chugger at least. Even putting back Spider Tank is something I would not have done. Oh, there we go.
I think it's a close call, because that's not the best to drop. MechWarp and Mad Scientist are way better in this matchup. And also, because he didn't have a one drop yet, and he's going first.
That's a fantastic draw, but turn one Keeper of the Grove.
Mm-hmm.
That's pretty crazy. Followed up by a Wild Growth on the turn after that.
Yep.
I remember back when I played Zoo a lot, most games you lose to Druid are because of turn one Keeper of the Grove. It's so good against aggressive decks.
Does that bring back bad memories right now?
Ah, good memories. Didn't lose much of that deck.
It's going to be really interesting what the Mirror End is going to do.
That draw was great.
Gives him a play the following turn as well. An option for a play as well outside of just Wrath and Hero Power, which is what he would have been left with.
Huh. This is kind of interesting.
Yeah, I think Ping Ping is going to play the 4-4, but that would walk into Swiped. I think you just play Mirror Entity.
Yeah.
Yeah, I like that thinking. What to do? The Swipe is so bad if he plays the Tinkerstone. But, yeah. He's gonna guarantee to get good value out of the Mirror Entity even here, but if you wait with it, you might get something even bigger.
I like playing it earlier rather than later. The later you play it, the more likely they are to have some little guy to throw away. That Innervate's not bad. Lets him kill Wrath as well as playing Piloted Shredder. Mm-hmm.
It could be a little risky, but it's sort of necessary because he would just be left with a Savage Roar in hand. And he would basically be top decking for plays for the next few turns. It would get rid of the option if he drew into an Ancient of Lore in the next couple turns to innervate it out.
Yeah, with this hand, I really can't blame him for rotting one here.
Yeah.
Lothub's a great draw here. It gives him a nice follow-up. Assuming Mirror Entity doesn't get played, which it might not, although it's tempting because you really want to use your freezing spare part to stop Powdered Shredder from killing the Tinkertown.
I actually really like the Mirror Entity here because Druid has so many 5-drops, and they're all kind of big. And you also, not only that, but you have the freeze spare part.
Yeah.
If you didn't have that one, then the Shredder would look better.
As long as you're going to get something that's stronger than Shredder, this turn is infinitely better.
It's a lot of late game in hand for the mage player.
Yeah.
See if it comes down to that point.
Ugh.
This what is my mirror entity. It's so good.
Yeah.
What do you do as Druid? You just, like, can't play stuff.
I think it just has to drop the load up as bad as it is.
Yeah, you have to get rid of that mirror entity eventually.
Yeah, I mean, next turn he might not draw anything smaller still, and it's just the same situation. He's gonna be not playing anything for many turns. It really feels bad, but I feel like he has to drop the load up.
Just gotta rip off that band-aid.
Alright, well, 9 points of damage in play for Mage. That freezing spare part was so good for stopping Powdered Shredder for a turn. Wow, even an Azurdrake, solid draw.
For sure.
I think you play that just for mana efficiency.
I would go for the Drake.
Fitter sticky. I mean,
yeah, whoa. That's true. I mean, it's very, very sticky.
I would have liked to see going face there, but I guess killing off the Keeper allows you to have the second half of your Piloted Shredder stay alive.
Well, he doesn't know it, but BGH is actually a pretty decent draw right now, but he's going to go ahead and play. Doesn't really have anything else to do.
Yeah, I would also play it here.
Yeah.
Like he doesn't have that many plays. He needs to get stuff on the board and just take the risk, but he's going to get some bad news next time.
You were in a similar situation earlier on, and sort of a similar thing happened to you where you used the BGH and something else came out the next turn, but...
I really think that it's correct to play it here.
Yeah,
the mage has only drawn 1/3 of his deck. So it's less likely for him to have it than not to have it.
This is why I would have liked Drake last turn, I think. Just, you really wanted a hero power this turn.
Yep. Or you could have even played a 2-drop, yeah. He could have played the Mech Warper or the Scientist. So he kind of wasted 1 mana on both turns.
Because now this is really awkward, because there's no way for him to take out that Lothub. So he either has to trade, not really down into the Big Game Hunter, but a really weird trade, or just go face.
I would like to see a trade here. His hand doesn't have burn, it has minions. So you want the game to go longer so you have time to play them.
Oh, wow.
He didn't need to go face there. No Savage Roar from Chalky, though. He did see one get played already, so it's a bit safer in that regard.
Always check first.
Yeah.
It's a lesson a lot of people learn the hard way.
It's definitely a good Piloted Shredder outcome if you're Chalky. Ping Ping did not want a zero attack minion there. I think we're going to see an Ancient Allure for heal, especially with Ragnaros to follow up. I don't think cards are what you need right now.
Yeah. He's really thinking it over, though, because he's wondering what the possibilities are for the next turn and if he needs something else from his deck besides Ragnaros to get him through this game.
He's saying about healing the 5-1, I think.
Yep, I was also thinking about it, but I don't know how much I like it.
I go face here.
He's still 1 turn away from the double fireball. Even though it's unlikely, it's still something that you have to account for.
Yeah. This threatens lethal if he's good, or draws Savage Roar. It depends on...
Force of Nature. Savage Roar. Either one would do it. Or Rack to Face. He can take the 1 out of 5.
I don't think Force does it. Or no, it is 12, yeah, you're right.
That's not good enough. Do you go for the 1 in 5?
Is that your best chance of winning? It might be. Trading off, you just probably die to Fireball, right?
Yeah, the trades are pretty bad, even if he's... He needs to trade off a 5-5 for that.
I would go for it.
It's a close call, because he can still get a lot of damage to face and potentially end next turn with the Rag.
Yeah, that's really, really risky. A 1 in 5 is not very good odds when he knows that if he does go for it, then he's pretty much for sure dead the following turn.
He's going to go for the swipe play.
I like the swipe first, because unless the boombox kill one of the 5/5s, they might soak up some damage.
Wow. Double ones.
Oh, this is pretty good.
Yeah, it's very good for Chalky.
Really, really, really good boombox there.
This is the
not even a fireball does it.
This is the weakest boombox I've ever seen.
Did you watch the last match?
Hello!
I think it's time to drop minions, hope for the best. Yeah. Oh, Frostbolt defensively.
Job's done. Wow.
He's got the fear.
Well, there's no way that Rag could end up ending the game this turn.
Nope.
Do you still play it then?
Absolutely.
Yes.
Goes to Shredder. I mean,
yeah, Shredder's just not gonna do
it. The hero of power is not that valuable, really. The Rag might kill one of those minions, and the Shredder might get something bit small.
Putting immediate impact on the board too, as opposed to the Shredder.
Yep. Such a close game. Because Ping Ho can seal this with a Fireball top deck, regardless of what happens. Unless the Shredder dies and something ridiculous comes out of it. I guess that's the only way.
Yeah. Chalky realized it. We'll see what this Rag hits. Face!
Fireball. Nope. Okay, so...
if he gets all four to the face. Well, not quite.
Nope. That's not bad.
Yeah, it could be a lot worse. He's still in it.
That's actually a pretty good outcome. This is ridiculous.
Alright, needs Chalky to brick to stay alive here.
There's so many cards he can draw.
Very unlikely. He's got a lot of outs.
Oh.
That's not one.
He can draw into Savage.
Yes, the last Savage draw. So it's 2 out of 16. 1 out of 8.
That's actually not that great odds, to be honest.
It might be his only chance of winning.
Even after that, though, he does have a chance to just Rag hit the face as well, but it's a 1 in 5 chance, which we said earlier. It's not the best.
He can get it down to 1 out of 4 by hitting the Mech Warper with Hero Power.
That's very
maybe
true.
Maybe you heal and then Hero Power, and then assuming you kill one of the bigger guys. You're at 11, you're at... Oh, man, this is tough.
No. Well, it actually... I think that might be the best play. Hero Power down to Mech
Warper. You know he doesn't have Fireball, because he'd be dead last turn.
He goes up to 10, so... Yeah, that's probably the best play. I mean, his outs were so slim.
Oh.
What does he get?
Haunted Creeper.
He's alive.
I can't believe this.
One off
again.
One health.
If that was a dual power minion.
And that's not going to do it. He's...
Wow. Oh, this is incredible.
Both players. One damage off, one draw off from finishing off the game.
So, play both minions, pop the spider.
Yeah.
Trade the... I don't know. Do you even trade?
Well, with the Annoyotron, not even Savage Roar is going to be an out for him. He's basically going to have to rely on...
The Rag.
Just the Rag next turn.
Or top deck Swipe or Keeper.
Keeper's going to kill you either way.
Yeah,
that's true.
I think killing Ancient Aura doesn't change anything. So if he considered every out in the deck, going face is a little bit better.
Yeah.
It does need to break the spider.
You're right. I don't think it's... Well, if he trades, then he is not dead to Druid of the Claw. Right? So he plays around Druid of the Claw with
that. Okay, that's a good point. I don't think we've seen any of those.
But
so.
Now, potentially, if the Rag hits the Archmage, then he's going to be off again.
Oh!
Wow.
All right, good trade.
Well, there it is.
So does Taunt come up here?
Or do you want to increase your chances of...
Winning the game?
Of Ragwin.
I mean, I think he should charge, because... That way, even if he kills the Archmage, he's still in good shape. So he has kind of like two good outcomes with that.
50-50.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I agree. It's probably his best odds.
Because if you taunt that up, the Archmage, if it survives, it can still kill the Druid of the Claw. So just improve the Rag odds here. And Hero Power, Druid of the Claw charge, take out the Annoyotron.
And again, it's still a chance that he just outright wins with the racket to the face.
Yes. I think I would have liked if Ping Ping Ho got that spider.
Ooh.
Oh. Okay.
Goes for the defensive play instead.
Wow.
Let's see if
there's still a chance.
Wow.
Oh, no.
Ping Ping didn't break the spider last turn.
Well.
What?
Chalky is still alive.
Yeah.
But barely. Not a spell.
What a game.
He needed, like, what, a frostbolt? He might have even been through both frostbolts.
Oh, man. That has to be stressful.
Very stressful.
Players.
One draw off from a victory for, what, three turns in a row now for both players, and Chalky was also just a lucky rag hit away from winning.
Yep. This all-time Ragnaros is just... Oh, man.
And Pimpy goes on the ropes here because this is his elimination game as well. So
if he loses
this one, he's out.
Yeah.
Chalky's got a little bit of wiggle room after this match as well. He's still got the blind pick phase ahead of him if he loses this game, but it's still a close one.
I think he has to trade off into... Well, does he have to trade off into Shredder?
Nope.
Let's give you a mirror entity.
It's still going to come back with Asta as a small one. And threaten the lethal, so.
Right.
Alright.
Guess we're going face.
Oh, jeez.
Still not breaking the spider.
So, keeper or swipe?
Alright.
Oh, that does it.
Alright.
That does it.
That's it.
Chalky
is going to take a 3-0 victory over Ping Ping Ho and move on to the semifinals. Very well played by him. Freeze Mage deck doing work. It looks like he made some good calls with his decks. And, of course, the patented Hunter victory with sacrificing the Leper Gnome.
Yeah, that's probably. That was, like, the best game I think I've casted so far, at least in this tournament that I've seen.
Turn 5 kill.
Yeah.
Yeah. the Hunter game, of course, is what you're talking about.
Right, yeah.
Yeah, that was very well played. Pimping Hill, of course, he had a great run through the tournament, a great run through the regular season as well. He won't go home empty-handed, of course, just for getting flown out here. He will go home with some money. But, of course, Chalky is going to be, I believe, the final player to move on to the semifinals. So we have all four of our semifinals: Chalky, Darkwonix, Silent Storm, and Zalay, who we haven't yet seen play today. So what do you guys think of that final four?
Yeah, all great players. Should be some good games.
I think Zalay has a really good shot at this, but I'm rooting for Darkwonix for sure. We're good buddies, so I hope he gets far.
Yeah, the Scandinavian synergy. Mm-hmm. Going on there. It's not to scoff at. Did you guys do some preparation together?
Yeah, we did some. We actually, like, not before the event, but once we got here, was the circumstance where that we kind of either not practice or we practice so that the other guy sees too. So we ended up, like, both finding out what the other guy's playing. And it's kind of fair.
Okay. Well, if tweet at us, guys, if tell us what you think about Chalky's victory, what you think about the semifinalists. That's hashtag HLS or at ESL. Hearthstone. Let us know what you think. Let us know how the tournament's going, how you feel, and who you're going to be rooting for as we move forward into the semifinals and the finals. But I'm super excited for watching these matchups that are going to come down. Savij, once again, thanks for joining us. An unfortunate run through the tournament, but I think you played pretty well through that one.
Thank you.
I think we are going to head over to the interview couch with Anna, who has a few words with Chalky.
Thank you so much, TJ. And yes, I am joined here with Chalky. Congratulations on that. Congratulations on that very clean 3-0 victory. How does it feel?
It feels really good. I mean, Ping Ping Ho got pretty unlucky, but I'll take anything I can get at this point. So happy to have a 3-0.
I mean, yeah, for a man that said that he left school in order to pursue Hearthstone professionally, that's definitely very good. So now let's talk a little bit about games 1 and 2, where you were facing a Kazan Mystic. Game 1, the Mech Shaman versus the Freeze Mage. How did that go?
Well, I'd actually played that matchup before against 6-0, my friend, and he actually got a Kazan Mystic off on my ice block, but it really didn't matter because, just like in game 1, he wasn't even close to killing me. And basically, I could have just popped the block anyway and then killed him later. So generally, in that matchup, as long as I draw my early cards like Mad Scientist and board clears, I can take it pretty easily.
Perfect. Now, let's talk a little bit. The Hunter-Druid game was just that. That was a very, very nice one to watch. Very, very quick.
Well, I'm happy. This is the first time I drew my one drops in my Hunter deck. The other two games that I played with it, I had no one drops. So that just shows the power of the deck when you draw those.
Yeah, it's all about drawing the right cards. And now the third game, tell us a little bit about what was going through your head when every turn you guys were so close to lethal, but not quite. Every turn.
Yeah, I was definitely happy with like how the early game panned out because that's a pretty bad matchup for Druid. And going into the late game, the Ragnaros, not quite on point, but my top decks were like good enough to keep me in the game, but not to win. And then when I saw the Wrath, I was just so happy to win, finally.
We could see it on your face. And don't say that about your Ragnaros. It did shoot face once, which was 8 damage, quite a bit. Now, any thoughts about your upcoming match with Zalea? Anything you would like to tell him personally?
I actually think Zalea is like a really good and underrated player. We haven't seen much of him, but in the ESL tournaments, he's been pretty dominant. So I'm excited to play against him, and I think the decks aren't really like out of my favor or anything, so it should be a good match.
Well, the best of luck to you, and the best of luck to everybody here. Now, for everybody that is currently watching, this is the Hearthstone Legendary Series Season 1 Finals. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back.